Ang mga tips ay ibabahagi sa atin ngayong umaga, of course, ng ating ever fabulous na sa Ms. Sheila Viesca, ang CEO ng Talk Shop. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the show. Welcome back. Diba?
Salamat.
O sige, straight
Hello,
to the
everyone.
Point.
Straight to the point.
O paano nga ba? Oh. No, pagka may bully.
Susuntukin na lang ba?
Siyempre, pagkatrabaho mo, nakasalalay dyan ang kinabukasan mo. Karaniwan. Ano ba yung kailangan mong malaman? O, tatlong tanong. Bakit siya galit sa'yo? Or bakit siya naiinis sa'yo?
Insecure.
Pwede? Or ano ba yung nagawa mo? Or, yung pangatlo, paano ba siya sa ibang tao?
The question also, ma'am, is when do you say na nabubuli ka na? Diba?
Yeah, isang magandang tanong yan, Angela, because just as there are different types of personality, there are different types of bullying. And it depends on the person perceiving the bullying. Kaya nga, titignan mo ng maayos, may nagawa ka ba rin sa isang tao? That person will usually make you feel oppressed or traumatized or tormented even without him realizing that he's doing that. There are just certain personality types that will clash with yours.
Yes, and you can't please everyone.
Yes. In the same manner, there are certain personality types that will complement yours. May mga kinaiinisan ka, pero dead man naman sila sa'yo. Meron namang gustong gusto mo, pero ayaw ka nila. And with that kind of chemistry in the workplace, it's really hard to figure out kung itong bullying to, intentional yung ginagawa sa'yo, or ganun lang siya talaga, or he is not even mindful of what he's doing.
Kasi may mga ganung tao na parang ganun lang siya sa lahat ng tao, parang binubuli niya talaga yung dating, ha? Kasi parang may pinagdadaanan din sila, di ba, sometimes.
That's right. And that's when it becomes clear to us that every time you point a finger to one person, how many fingers are pointed back at you?
Four.
Hindi pwedeng four, eh. Kasi
three.
Hindi normal ang issue.
Three. So, dapat ganyan, di ba?
Oo. That you are always more in control.
Dapat ganun.
Point of fingers. Point of fingers.
So, if there's a situation that you feel that you're being oppressed, bullied, tormented, then you have to practice introspection. Ano ba yung nagawa mo at bakit itong tao ganito sa'yo? Okay, for instance, people who are multitaskers, who are concentrated on the processes, on the task, tend to be insensitive most times to the feelings of others. And if you are the type of person who wants sensitivity, sensibility from your colleagues, pag medyo hindi ka nila napansin or nabigyan ng attention according to the attention that you want to get, baka masakit na sa'yo. When in fact, they did not even realize that they're causing you harm. Na ikaw pala masyadong
sensitive
hurt na hurt.
Balat si Buya.
So Ma'am Sheila, talagang it's also the intention is very important. To know the intention, whether the person is really just like that or maraming iniisip, or yung intention nila is really to just be, to be a bully. Parang gano'n. Kailangan malaman na yun.
That's very true. Because one consideration that we have is that individuals have the tendency to project. If the person lacks self-awareness, whatever he lacks in himself or whatever has worked for him, he will tend to project on other people without considering their own processes. So, pag ganyan, hindi mo nakasalanan yun. Kailangan lang iiwas mo yung sarili mo sa sitwasyon na nandyan yung mga bullies, iiwasan mo ba or hindi mo lang dadamdamin because that person is just naturally crass towards you.
But say kung wari, talagang inevitable na makakasama mo siya, hindi mo pwede iwasan, and you're really uncomfortable na working with the person, how do you properly address the person? Parang, i-confront mo ba siya? Or dapat bang sabihin mo sa, say kung wari, sa mas superior sa'yo, para siya yung kumausap doon sa tao? Paano po yung dapat?
Maselan yan, especially if the person is your boss, right? Paano kung yung boss mo has a tendency to bully you and he does not even realize he's doing that? Or kung intentional niyang ginagawa yun, paano mo rin gagawin? One is, of course, to go directly to the person para malaman mo yung punong dulo. Yes. Confront in a way that will make that person tell
realize
kung ano yung pwede mong i-adjust sa situation. If there's something that you can do about it, then work with that person. Kasi pag hindi self-aware, no amount of explanation from your part will help that person. yung default reactions niya, yung mga tendencies niya, will always bring him back to that kind of reasoning. Mm. Unfortunately, the person's personality type determines his leadership style. Mm-hmm. So, kung gusto mong intindihin, kung sa palagay mo, kakayanin ng puso mo, then go for it. Mm-hmm. If the person is in his right frame of mind, then you can talk to that person. If not, then it's your call to reframe your thinking. Mm-hmm. You have to take yourself out of the frame so you can control the game. Pag masyado kang involved sa bullying situation, then all throughout your day, yan ang concentration mo. Mm-hmm. Ano ba yung gagawin ko?
Oh. Ito na naman,
paano ko ba siya aatakihin? Paano ba pagagalingin yung trabaho ko? So it's all about mm-hmm. that person. It stops mm-hmm. becoming about your career, about your contribution mm-hmm. to yes. your company. About your personal effectiveness.
Mm. And I think, ma'am, it's also important that the person should consider yung workplace niya. Like, for mm-hmm. example, masyado siyang feeling niya na sisigawan and everything. Eh, ang workplace niya is in a newsroom na talagang uh-oh. Intense lahat ng tao. So, don't take that personally diba, against the people. Kasi talagang, at that time, yung pagka-work period na, talagang mga intense yung mga tao, laging galit kasi may nahabol na news, like ito, like that, diba? So, dapat hindi rin siya masyado
sensitive
yeah. diba, yung balat sibuyas.
Yeah, it's actually good that this issue of bullying is being addressed in schools. Mm-mm. Para malaman din ng mga kabataan kung ano yung healthy relationship, healthy environment. Now, when we mature, we expect to meet mature individuals who know better. Mm. But that's not the case. So, paano pag ganun, bawasan mo yung pakiging balat sibuyas mo? Because mm. that's the reality of the situation. Mm. A diverse work situation usually prospers more. Mm-hmm. Pero hindi may iwasan dyan na merong mga perfectionists. Ano yan? Mm. Oh. These people will never be happy with whatever you do. Because their own they have their own standards. Mm-hmm. Na kahit ma-meet mo,
hindi pa rin sila happy. Yes.
Oo. There are people who are naturally bossy. Tendency to be aggressive. Sometimes hindi nila alam, they don't catch themselves, they're already lashing out at you. Mm-hmm. Huwag mong masyadong dibdibin, huwag mong masyadong personalin. And that question about the person's intention is very important. Mm-hmm. Before you plan your counterattack, ask first. Bakit kaya?
Bakit ba?
Ano kaya nagawa ko? Ano kaya problema niya? Di ba? Kasi kung bully siya, hindi mo naman problema yun eh. You can always take yourself out of the situation. Yes. Well, that person will forever be stuck with himself.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I would just like to ask
Go ahead.
Kasi it's persons who have low self-esteem, could it be a reverse personality just to defend themselves and they become bully?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Thank you for that question. Totoo yan, Doc. Sabi nga sa psychology, an oppressed child becomes an oppressor. Mm-hmm. An abused person becomes an abuser. Yeah, mm-hmm. Without self-awareness, the critical situations that have brought out the worst in that person, mm-hmm. whenever the person encounters them, usually may mga reaction siya directed towards individuals na wala namang kasalanan. Mm-hmm. Yes. Pag ganun ang mga sitwasyon, syempre, kailangan mag-introspection yung tao, kailangan magkaroon ng intervention. Eh, hindi naman ikaw yung psychologist ng tao eh. Mm-hmm. Diba? You can only do so much. You can only extend or broaden your sense of compassion. Once again, take yourself out of the frame so you can control the game. Nice. Oo, intindihin mo ang sitwasyon. Mm-hmm. And if it is unhealthy already, that it's affecting your personal life, mm-hmm. social life, your love life, mm-hmm. kung ano yung problema mo sa boss mo, na ilalash out mo sa kasamahan mo sa bahay. Diba?
Then, all right. So bottom line po talaga is do not be consumed by the idea of being bullied.
Yes. Diba? Well said.
So talagang focus siguro move on with your life, channel your emotions to other things. Yes. Diba? Yes. Alright, before we let you go, saan po nila kayo pwedeng makontak?
We can be reached at Talk Shop in Makati. The telephone number is 894-5588, mm-hmm. 0917-853-5588. And we have programs that address confidence building issues and also self-esteem issues. Yeah. importanteng-importante yan.
Yes.
Na ang tao, matutunan niyang i-affirm kung ano yung maganda sa kanya.
True.
Because it's only by working on those foundations that you can enrich the other dimensions of yourself.
Wow, very well said. Alright, maraming salamat po sa inyo, Ma'am Sheila Viesca. Siya po ang CEO ng Talk Shop.